They've killed more than 170 people in our state already this year. Alcohol-related crashes.
Tonight, WNCN is continuing our in-depth look at the DWI problem in our state, and we want to know who's keeping tabs on those cases once they go to court.
Our investigative reporter, Jonathan Rodriguez, shows us what our team uncovered.
Well, Sean Chan, this started as a project just to spread awareness about how detrimental drunk driving is. But when we started to take a close look at how many arrests actually lead to a conviction, the numbers just weren't adding up. So we promised we'd work to try and find out why so many cases were being dismissed.
Drive over the limit and you're under arrest. Night after night, law enforcement officers take people into custody for driving while impaired, but it doesn't end here.
He said, I've had too much to drink. I should not be driving.
Everyone gets their day in court, and it's here that WNCN Investigates found a shockingly inconsistent number of DWI cases being thrown out. The state average for DWI dismissals is about 21%. Some counties like Durham and Wake are below that average, but in Vance, Granville, Lee, and Harnett, nearly half of all DWIs are being dismissed.
It certainly is a red flag that requires somebody to explain something.
And with such a discrepancy between dismissal rates, it begged the question, why? So we started at the top. Vernon Stewart is the district attorney for Lee and Harnett counties. We tried several times to ask him why Harnett had the highest dismissal rate in the state, but he turned down all of our requests for on-camera interviews. So we kept digging and found the next key to the story. A simple document required by state law that says prosecutors have to give detailed reasoning anytime they dismiss a DWI case.
It was more to create a transparency for dismissals that up until that point had been shrouded in mystery.
The Administrative Office of the Courts is responsible for these forms, and Judge John Smith is the director.
They should be more easily available. I mean, we don't contest that.
And we asked the AOC for all the documents for Harnett County, but it turns out their databases are so old, this is from the 1980s, that they never kept track of them.
They're buried in each individual case file. Lawmakers passed a bill for these documents to be part of a new integrated data system so that the AOC and the public could keep tabs on things like high dismissal rates. That was 8 years ago. So why hasn't it been done?
Our budgets have been continually cut instead of increased.
So it all comes down to funding?
It comes down to paying for the rewrite of that database.
A task Judge Smith says would cost close to $25 million.
To date, they hadn't really done anything to provide that transparency.
It's a problem highlighted in a 2013 audit that calls out the AOC for lack of transparency. And State Auditor Beth Wood says it's been long enough.
You would think for something this important, statutorily mandated, and over 8 years now, they get $29 million a year. They haven't been able to come up with $25 million to provide the transparency to the citizens of North Carolina. I just have to step back and say, are they really trying?
So with no other choice, we hit the file room in Harnett County and went through every single closed DWI case from 2012 and 2013 to try and find our answer why.
As it is now, it requires some labor, as you probably know from having done the research, to get that information, and it's harder to get, but it's not impossible to get.
More than 550 files later, we were left with a myriad of excuses and a lot more questions. The so-called all-telling document was anything but. Some documents were only halfway filled out. Others gave no detailed explanation.
Is that the way these forms are supposed to fill out? Is that the time?
No. The statute clearly says that there should be a more detailed statement.
Of the cases dismissed, about 18% were thrown out because officers were not showing up in court. Another 23% had no probable cause. Cases are getting dismissed because prosecutors aren't able to prove impairment, even when the drivers were above the legal limit. Like this one, the file says the driver blew a .16, but because the officers didn't show up, the case was dismissed. That driver had two previous DWIs. And this one that was thrown out because of unavailable witnesses. The file says this driver was nearly three times over the legal limit.
Who's looking at these forms? Who's checking to make sure that these reasons are valid?
Well, I assume the elected DA who manages his staff.
But is there any checks and balances?
Do you mean is the AOC going out and looking? No, we do not.
I believe it is their responsibility to look at these dismissal rates and look into why some are not a little higher, but a lot higher than the state's average.
We have a situation in a county that has the highest dismissal rate in the state, a DA who doesn't want to talk about it, even though he is an elected official, and numbers that aren't consistent with a statewide dismissal rate. Yeah. So when is it an opportunity for the AOC to step in?
Well, that is a difficult question. It has to do with staffing and available resources.
Judge Smith believes a system upgrade is coming soon, but says it's in the hands of lawmakers.
It seems to me that they ought to be able to find the funds to help us.
Until then, he says while the problem may have many players, the answer should be in one place.
It's the elected DAs who are ultimately responsible.
Now on Friday, District Attorney Stewart again declined to go on camera, but did agree to give us a statement saying, quote, my office takes seriously our role in the prosecution of all criminal cases, including DWI offenses. WNCN's efforts and inquiries are certainly appreciated and have given us cause to look into our existing policies and procedures to make changes as necessary. Now he also says his biggest challenge is a lack of funding and that they're understaffed. We have all of his comments on our website, WNCN.com. In the meantime, the state auditor says she will be back to the AOC to see what progress has been made there. I'm Jonathan Rodriguez, WNCN News.
Jonathan, fantastic work. You can see the first two parts of our investigation into the broader epidemic of drunk drivers right now on WNCN.com. You can also join in the conversation on Twitter by using the hashtag BoozeItLoseIt.